Ready to do your planning in SAP Analytics Cloud and wondering where to start? The first thing you will need is a planning model. And you'll probably want to start from a blank model, which allows you to define the model structure from scratch before you import your data. Here, you will be using the new model type. In a new model, dimensions for version and date are created automatically. You begin with a single version for actuals. When the model is complete, you can add other versions by importing data to the model or generating data in stories using a range of ad hoc and structured planning features. In the date dimension, you can set the default booking behavior for values, either distributing the values across all levels of the default hierarchy or booking them to an unassigned member. Next, you can specify the time range you want to cover. And set the time granularity to the smallest unit of time you want to plan on. Keep in mind that finer granularities generate more data. You can open the model preferences for additional date and time options, such as optionally enabling a week-based date pattern for planning, or changing the default period name label. If your fiscal year doesn't match the calendar year, you can enable the fiscal year option and choose the appropriate settings. The model is enabled for planning by default. You can choose the date dimension to use for planning if the model contains more than one, and optionally change the default data disaggregation settings for data locks and validation rules. Models support data in multiple currencies by default, but if you want to aggregate those values to allow planning using different currencies, you need to enable currency conversion. In this case, you won't be using currency conversion. Next, you can add the remaining dimensions to the model, either by creating new ones or by adding existing public dimensions. You can start with the model's organization dimension, which is where you specify the currencies in which you'll be importing or entering data for the model. You can add a hierarchy and open the dimension to enter or copy and paste IDs and descriptions for all the members, define the hierarchy structure, and enter the currency in which you will either import or enter the values for each member. Optionally, you can also specify the user who will be assigned planning task by default for each dimension member. With the model currency set, you can define the measures you want to work with. You can create measures as separate objects, specifying names and details for each individual item, or optionally create an account dimension with multiple account values stored in a single measure. In this case, you'll create a single measure to hold the values for all accounts. Here, you need to set the unit type to currency, and either choose a single currency or show each member's value in the currency set in the model's organization dimension. Keep in mind that here, the model has data in US dollars and euros, and currency conversion is not enabled, so the values in different currencies can't be aggregated. In this case, you need to use the From Dimension option, so the currency details for each dimension member are preserved. When currency conversion is not enabled and you create a single measure to store the values for all accounts, the Fixed option treats the model data as being in a single currency and ignores the settings from the model's currency column. Now you can create a new account dimension that specifies all the individual accounts that will have values stored in the account measure. Each member needs an ID and a description. You can build a hierarchy of your accounts by specifying the parent account for each member up to the root level. There are many specific options for customizing the attributes for individual accounts, such as formula, where you can use functions and operators to calculate values based on other accounts, account type, where you can classify accounts as income, expense, asset, liability and equity, or non-financial, and threshold, where you can define ranges to classify values as OK, warning, or critical to change how associated values display in stories. Other options apply to all measures, such as aggregation settings and units and currencies. Next, because the model uses an account dimension rather than separate measures, you need to set the structure priority in the model preferences to prioritize properties and calculations from the account dimension. You can complete the model structure by creating generic dimensions for any other relevant ways of dividing or aggregating values, such as product information. Including a hierarchy with any parent-child relationships. Once your dimensions are ready, you can save the model. Success! Now that the model structure is complete, you can import the data into it from the data management workspace. Alternatively, you can manually enter data for versions such as budgets or forecasts in tables, or use structured planning features such as data actions or allocations to generate values. These steps are covered in other videos. For more details on how to set up models for planning, check out the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.